open your textbooks. Today, we will read chapter number 3. Now, copy down whatever you see on the blackboard.
These are instructions that we have heard in language classrooms pretty often. But we need to think what kind of learning opportunities do they provide to the learners. Regular classroom practices offer limited scope for independent or autonomous learning. It more often present teachers as the sole authority on the subject and students as passive recipients. To bring positive change in this perspective, we have made autonomy a central pillar of the CLIx course design.
Learners' independence or autonomy means students can make mistakes and take control of their learning. They self-pace themselves and are usually motivated and feel confident about their learning. They get to choose what they want to learn as opposed to learning what was chosen for the whole class.
So what are some strategies that CLIx English teachers use to promote autonomy? Let's find out.
When students enter the lab, initiate a brief discussion about their last session. Each pair may be on a different lesson. That's okay. Ask them to recall their last activity. Encourage them to continue from where they had stopped. This can motivate them to take charge of their learning.
तो मुझे पता चल जाता था कि वो अगर इस एक्टिविटी में जाएंगे तो उन्हें जरूर मेरा हेल्प जरूरी होगा. तो मैं उन्हें कहती कि तुम यहाँ पे मुझे हेल्प के लिए बुलाना. तो मैंने धीरे-धीरे देखा कि अब एडजस्ट मैंने कर लिया.
Independent learning can also be promoted by motivating students to use the learning resources creatively and independently. So, whenever you notice your students struggling to complete any activity, encourage them to use CLIx help videos, CLIx posters, and word clouds before giving a solution to their problem.
Actually, when I interfere too much, as they have seen in the class 10 room, no, I used to tell them, if you look at that your last mistake is your best teacher. So,
students are usually scared to make errors. Please remember that allowing them to make mistakes is important for learning. Always remind your students that it is absolutely fine to make mistakes. Instead of dismissing their mistakes as a hurdle to learning, evaluate them first and ask your students to reflect on them. Reflection helps in fostering autonomy meaningfully. Encourage your learners to note down their learning experiences and their observations. For example, instead of receiving convenient responses, such as recording was difficult, ask for more detailed responses on the nature of problem. Otherwise, you will never know if their issue was with sentence construction, speaking, or the use of technology.
Classrooms are complex spaces where every learner has a different learning pace and learning capacity.
See, normally they are very competitive. One pair is doing faster than the other pair. They tend to rush, and you know, they used to try to complete that particular lesson and try to catch up their friends. So after telling them that, I think they were like more at ease now. So they were working at their own pace, you know, not trying to worry much about what the others are doing.
In regular classrooms, students often compare their learning gains with their peers. This affects them significantly, making them feel nervous and uncomfortable. When students start showing such signs, help them by using phrases such as, "It is okay, you can work at your own pace. Try doing it in a different way."
As facilitators, limit your interference and involvement to those situations where students might need help. Else, allow them to happily explore. Provide opportunities to make mistakes. Encourage students to self-pace themselves and select their learning styles. When students confidently start sharing questions and their doubts and start accepting responsibilities for their learning, it is a sign that you're fostering autonomy in your language classroom. Thank you.